Now, what is silent gap or what is auscultatory gap? In severely hypertensives, after first appearance of sounds, occasionally it gets disappears near to the point around 200 mmHg and appears in a range around 20 to 50 mmHg and later finally disappears at the point of diastolic blood pressure. The period of first temporary disappearance of sound is called silent gap or auscultatory gap. To avoid this gap, first measure systolic blood pressure with the palpatory method. That's how and that's why we first have to measure the systolic blood pressure with the help of palpatory method before the beginning of the auscultatory method. Now, let's take example. Patient's actual blood pressure is 230 mmHg or 230 mmHg, which is the patient's actual blood pressure when the first time sound appears. Around 200 mmHg, the sound disappears. Within a gap of 20 to 50 mmHg, at the level of 160 mmHg, the sound reappears. Here, the sound disappears, and here, at that point, the sound reappears. And around 100 mmHg, the sound finally disappears. This portion is known as silent gap. If we try to measure the blood pressure directly with the auscultatory method, and if we fail to raise the mercury in the mercury manometer above the 250 mmHg of the level, then we are going to miss this silent gap. If we raise the mercury in the mercury column of the 180 mmHg, then what will happen? The first sound we will hear, it is at the level of 160 mmHg, and second sound will be at the level of 100 mmHg. So we considered that 160 mmHg will be our systolic blood pressure. But it's absolutely a wrong thing. First, you have to measure the systolic blood pressure with the help of palpatory method, and you have to raise the pressure around 30 mmHg above the level of palpatory method while you are measuring with the help of auscultatory method. That's how we are not going to miss the silent gap or auscultatory gap in a severely hypertensive patients.